apparently truly being king of the world requires you to explore every nook and cranny of it. James Cameron's Deepsea Challenge is a documentary about director James Cameron's quest to build a submarine that would take him to the bottom of the deepest part of the ocean and discover what lies 36,000 feet beneath the waves. Though this film is primarily a scientific exploration, it also touches on Cameron's reputation as a taskmaster and the consequences his leadership style and drive have both on his team and the task. It's certainly a pretty impressive feat to attempt, but the question remains, is the movie as impressive as its subject matter? Well, probably not. I think for a movie like this, it really comes down to how much interest you hold in the topic at hand. If you find deep sea exploration interesting, you will love this movie. If you'd rather chew glass than think about what lies below the ocean surface, well, good news. You don't have to do either. And also, I doubt you'll like this movie. Now, for me, I enjoyed the exploration, as I'm usually a fan of these types of pioneering endeavors. So I found much of the movie to be really engaging and interesting. It actually kind of reminded me of those museum movies that you watch on your way into the museum that supposedly give you the information you need to enjoy the museum, but really serve to space out people's entry so it doesn't get too crowded. They often seem very academic and informational, and I actually kind of like that. And this movie is no different. It was actually kind of refreshing to see an old school documentary that simply taught me something rather than trying to indoctrinate me. Plus, there's an event halfway through the shooting of this movie that brings a true human element to the proceedings that I found to be raw and vulnerable. But the bad thing is, there really isn't much beyond that. As interesting as the information is, there isn't much that would make this stand out over many shows already on the Discovery Channel. It's interesting to watch how Cameron's arrogance and curiosity combine with his wealth to make it happen, but there really isn't much payoff to it other than the thing itself. Other than some out of nowhere forced underwater wristwatch commercial, but that's about it. In fact, I found much of the story and footage of Cameron's previous dives to the Titanic and a warship that were included in this to be even more interesting than the ultimate trek to get to the bottom of the ocean, which should tell you something about the overall experience. By the time it's over, James Cameron's Deepsea Challenge proves to be an interesting and informative look at what it takes to explore the untouched depths of the deepest part of the ocean. If you love science and are curious about exploration, you might have a lot to like here. But if that doesn't interest you, there won't be much here to hold your attention. For me, I thought it met the challenge to the tune of a B-. Thanks for checking out this Your Movie Friend review. Stay tuned for this review's best ever challenge here in a bit. But first, I want to throw some stuff up over here you can click on. If you'd like to subscribe, which I'd very much appreciate, you can do that by clicking on the big gray subscribe button. Want to see more? Well, I also have reviews this week of Into the Storm, Step Up, All In, The 100-Foot Journey, and Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. You can also click the logo right up here to go to the all-new YourMovieFriend.com, where you can find a searchable database of reviews, as well as the written text of these videos. And finally, this review's best ever challenge, where you name the best movie ever in a particular category, and also try to identify my choice. What is the best underwater movie ever? Cameron certainly has his own entry into this category, but I'm partial to the one that involves Dustin Hoffman and Sharon Stone. Drop your own answer and a guess at mine in the comments, and the first person to guess mine does get that point. Thanks, and please subscribe.